When a water pipe burst, the challenge was to fix it fast. What we learned tonight from 7 News reporter Zach Grady, Watertown crews faced other challenges during that water emergency a couple of weeks ago, ones that they had to tackle before they could even start thinking about fixing the pipe.
Watertown Water Department workers faced 3 major challenges when dealing with this water main break last month that put the city into a state of emergency. First, crews could not dig to find the leak for hours.
If there's a problem located for gas or for electric, it's not unusual for us to have to wait 5 to 10 hours.
Crews waited 11 hours in this case, waiting for the okay from National Grid because of major electrical and gas lines near the water break. City crews used tools just like these T-handled wrenches to turn off 25 valves stopping the water flow. The process took 12 hours as some of those valves required up to 270 turns to close the valves.
Given the fact that they're transmission mains, they're larger and they're spread out. So it's not like a light switch.
Another concern, finding where the fix needed to be done in the first place. Maps were not the best, some drawn up nearly a century ago.
We're also doing some geolocations for valves because apparently the old documents we had were drawn instead of geolocated.
As the water department answered questions Wednesday night at a special city council meeting, lawmakers commended crews for the work they did to get the water back on. Zach Grady, 7 News.